come in. My pet. My, my. What an unexpected surprise. To what do I owe the pleasure? No, no, you're not intruding at all. Quite the contrary, in fact. I was just thinking about you, my darling. Oh, yes. It's never a question of if you're occupying my thoughts. No, the real question is, which part of you am I thinking of? So many delectable choices. Busy with what exactly? These dusty old books, each of which I've read at least a dozen times? Counting the bricks in the fireplace? All 527 of them? Well, no matter. The point is, I'm never too busy for your company, my darling. There's no interruption I wouldn't suffer, if it means getting to see your lovely face. Speaking of which, come in, my dear. Close the door, why don't you? These halls are rather drafty. Good. Come here. Yes. Look at me, my darling. You heard me. While I'm sure the carpet appreciates your gaze, your master would appreciate it far more. Look at me, my pet. Or do you perhaps need a little help? Not to worry. Let me just place my fingers under your chin. And with a delicate tug. There. Yes. Much better. Now, what do you say? Good girl. My, where's this newfound obedience coming from? Surely I haven't managed to smother the spark of yours just yet. That's good to hear. After all, what's the fun of a new toy if it breaks too soon? You look especially lovely tonight, my pet. That dress is the one I gave you, isn't it? Do you like it? Strange. I've never seen you wear it. Perhaps it was just all another act of defiance. I had known you would look radiant in it. Yet, you would sooner let it rot in the wardrobe than admit I was right. The way the fabric wraps you in its embrace. The way your scent drifts out from beneath it. Knowing that one thin layer of cloth is all that stands between me and that tender flesh. I wonder, where shall I feed from tonight? What do you think, my pet? Where would you like to feel your master's fangs? Yes, I'll allow you to choose. If you do one small thing for me, tell me, darling. Why are you here? No, I'm not talking about our deal. We both know how you came to be in my castle. No, I'm talking about here, in this room. After months of avoiding me whenever possible, months of tensing like a cornered rabbit every time you're in my presence, why would you suddenly seek me out? Come now, my pet. Did you think I wouldn't notice you dodging my question earlier? Why are you here? Be a good girl and answer me. I'd hate to have to force it out of you. I thought so. You heard, then, about our little rat problem. Apparently my guards had quite an exciting time the other night. I thought my traps would be enough to ward off any potential pests, but it seems I was mistaken. Several of your old associates were caught attempting to force their way into the castle. Unfortunately for them, I've strengthened my security quite a bit, given that I have something so valuable to protect. Under, shall we say, questioning, they admitted they were trying to get you. A so-called rescue mission. They now sit rotting in the dungeon, awaiting their fate. Oh yes, they're alive. Missing a few pieces here and there, but alive, nonetheless. What will I do with them? What do you think, darling? Spare them? My, that's quite a big request now, isn't it? After all, they threatened my home, went against the terms of peace I so clearly laid out, injured several of my men. But more than that, they dared to think they could try and take you. They dared to try and touch what's mine. My precious pet, my jewel, my angel, my darling, you are mine. Oh, trust me, I won't kill them. No, they don't deserve mercy. Instead, I think I'll turn them. Yes, I'll turn them into my immortal slaves, and let them watch as I claim you over and over and over again for as long as I desire. Well, well, what have we here? Begging, and on your knees no less. I won't deny that I enjoy the sight. Those flea-bitten rats truly mean that much to you? In that case, I wonder, just how far would you be willing to go to save them? Just how much would you be willing to offer me? If it was their immortality or yours, which would you choose? I think you know what I mean, darling. You're asking for the ultimate mercy from me. It's only fair that you should have to prove your loyalty in return. Would you swear yourself to me for eternity in order to save them? Was this my plan all along? Come now. You can't expect me to reveal all my secrets. Still, you ought to know by now, my dear. Wherever you are, I'm always two steps ahead. Oh, I wouldn't call it torment. More like a little reminder to know your place. I'd hate for you to grow complacent. After all, if you... What the... Brat! What the hell are you... So, you want to play rough, do you? Naughty girl. And here I was thinking I'd finally managed to teach you some manners. Oh, my pet. I promise you'll regret this. Enough! Not another word. Be still unless you want me to snap these pretty little wrists. You know, I do enjoy you kneeling, but this, having you pinned to the wall, my body pressed against yours, I'll have to remember this. Now, are you ready to behave? Oh, my fiery, foolish pet. I'd expect nothing less. I'll let you think on my offer for a while. Just remember why you submitted to me to begin with. My power is unfathomable. Your pathetic friends could never have hoped to defeat me. And neither can you. Just like before, their only hope lies in your surrender. For now, though, there are more pressing matters. Yes, your scent, that soft skin, Tilt your head to the side. Now. Yes. That burn. That spice of suppressed rage. I live for that moment when you stop resisting. That moment when you yield, going limp in my arms. The moment you accept that you are mine. Oh, dear me. Perhaps I went a bit overboard this time. Shh. It's all right, my dear. Not to worry. I've got you. But before you drift off, tell me, who do you belong to? To Tyron? My poor little pet. Allow me to refresh your memory. You are mine. Say it. Good girl. That's right. You are mine. Now and for all eternity. What's up, Wolfpack? It's Wolf0, back with another video. I do hope you enjoyed part 3 of the Sadistic Vampire series. A quick shout out to Rit Savvy for once again writing another very interesting script. Always love recording her stuff, it's always very fun to do so. But, as per usual, please go into the link in the description down below and check out the ASMR RP Lounge Discord server, where you will find many very talented ASMR artists, as well as the fans who love to listen to them. The server is just about always active, and there's always something going on in the VC, so if that sounds like something you're interested in, feel free to check it out. Now, with that being said, thank you all for listening this far into the audio, and I will catch you all in the next one. Later.